once again,
Excellency, President, welcome indeed. Warm welcome to your very close neighbor. Yes. We will begin and perhaps do our welcoming remarks with, in the open mic, then thereafter we'll close. We are very happy that we have this bi-national. I just want to start by introducing my delegation at the, no, let me start this side. Yes. The lady sitting at the end is the Minister of Energy. The next to her, another lady, Minister of Labor. Next to her, another lady, Minister of Environment Affairs. Next to her, a gentleman, Minister of Telecommunications. Next to the Minister of Telecommunications is a man who is a double citizen. He's a Zimbabwean and he's a South African as well. The South African ambassador in Zimbabwe. At the side of me is a Minister of International Relations and Cooperation. Next to her, the Minister of Defense. Next to her is the Minister of Trade and Industry. Next to the Minister of Trade and Industry is Minister of Sport and Recreation. He can run very fast. He's a sprinter. He's a sprinter. Yes, the last one is the Minister of Transport. thank you very much indeed for that. Let me do my opening remarks. Your Excellency and dear brother, President Robert Mugabe, honorable ministers, both sides, our respective ambassadors, of course, we call them high commissioners.
This side of me.
Oh, I thought that was the remnants of the British. They left. Oh, okay. Thank you. Thank you, the senior government officials, members of the media. Good morning to you all. It is with great pleasure that we welcome you, Mr. President, and your esteemed delegation. We thank you for honoring our invitation to the second session of our valued bi-national commission. Your Excellency, we are both committed to adhere to Article 6 of the BNC agreement, which stipulates that the two countries should meet annually. I still vividly recall the warm welcome and generous hospitality extended to me and my delegation during the inaugural session of the DNC in Harare last November. Our historical, fraternal, and cultural bonds demand that we meet on a regular basis to strengthen and consolidate our bilateral cooperation and partnership. Your Excellency, we note with satisfaction the ever-growing cooperation between our two countries, as evidenced by the existing 40 agreements and memoranda of understanding. These agreements are aimed at promoting political, economic, and social cooperation. They cover a wide range of areas, including double taxation, justice, defense, transport, water, science and technology, health, migration, labor, economic and trade cooperation, and tourism, to mention but a few. We also need to ensure the full implementation of these agreements. We are thus happy that the ministers and officials have developed monitoring mechanisms such as mid-term reviews. This will go a long way to assist in the implementation agenda. My President, I wish to underscore the strategic significance of a one-stop border post at the Great Bridge border. This border post is the busiest border post on the continent. Much of our goods and services go through it. We cannot afford to continue to have unnecessary delays at that border. It is therefore important and urgent that we start in earnest a process of establishing a one-stop border post. Our two countries took a decision to do so as far back as 2009. In this regard, we direct the relevant ministers and officials to move with speed and report progress at the next bi-national commission. Your Excellency, South Africa has just assumed the chairship of SADC at the 37th SADC Summit, and I personally look forward to working with you, Mr. President, in championing the theme endorsed at the summit. Mr. President, issues of connectivity and information technology and communications should also be addressed for the region to benefit from the fourth industrial revolution. In this regard, it is worth noting that SADC ministers responsible for communications and ICT met in South Africa from the 5th to the 7th September 2017 with the aim of establishing communication systems that are accessible, affordable, efficient, reliable to a ensure connectivity to the citizens of the Sahel region. Connectivity will ensure the attainment of the goals for regional economic integration, poverty alleviation, and industrialization. Mr. President, on the 17th August 2017, I presided over the official launch of the African Regional Center of the BRICS New Development Bank in Sandton, Johannesburg. We envisage through this bank the development of initiatives which will ultimately contribute to the implementation of the SADC industrialization strategy and the AU Agenda 2063. Mr. President, we find ourselves in challenging times, considering the effects of the El Nino phenomenon, which devastated our economies. This phenomenon has contributed to poor harvests in the region due to lack of sufficient rains, thus negatively affecting our GDP growth, which is mostly agricultural based. We need to put our heads together to find solutions to this challenge. Your Excellency, we meet in the month of October, which is the month of the birth of our late O.R. Tambo. I personally know that you had various interactions with Comrade Tambo during his lifetime as the president of the ANC. Upon attaining Zimbabwe's independence, it was Comrade Tambo himself who personally approached you to discuss the possibility of opening the ANC office in Harare. Then it was still called Salisbury. You were aware of the risks associated with accepting such a request, yet you concurred. O.R. Tambo himself spoke proudly of you, Your Excellency, during the 8th Conference of Heads of State and Government of Non-Aligned Countries held in Harare in September 1986, where he said, and I quote, "As chairman, you have taken over as chief of staff of a movement that has transformed itself into a task force that will fight in both the forward and rear echelon the process of the total liberation of Africa, to which the victory of the struggle in Zimbabwe made and is making such a historic contribution. Under your courageous, experienced, and foresighted leadership, we are certain to march to victory." Close quote. The battles we face today are of a different kind. Our struggles are about to are about the economic emancipation of our people. While this remains a challenging task, I am certain that our joint efforts will lead us there. Once again, we welcome you, Mr. President, and we look forward to the deliberations of our two delegations. I thank you very much. Associated with in our struggle. Vibrant, outspoken, forward going and never going backwards. But now the stroke had taken him. He could recognize me. Shall always remember him together as a freedom fighter who's even a national hero, as we call those of our own who distinguish themselves in the fight against imperialism. So we remember him together. So continue forever to rest in peace. Comrade President, I am delighted. the synchronization of by National Commission. I wish to thank you, Comrade President, and the people and government of South Africa for your fraternal welcome and wonderful hospitality. We are very comfortable at heart. When we come here, we know we are coming to our second home. Comrade President, it is often said that one can choose his her friends, but he cannot choose one's neighbors. Let me assure you that had we had a say in the choice of a neighbor, we still would have chosen. We are one family because of our geography. Of our history. Of the revolutionary struggle that we fought side by side. And of course of culture. And blood, totems, and marriage, and we hope that these phenomena will continue to bind us forever. I'm pleased that we have chosen the path of cooperation, consultation, dialogue, engagement, and joint action in order to secure our common future. We meet today in that common spirit. Ever since we met at the inaugural session of our bi-national commission, much has been done to bring to fruition the decisions we took on that occasion. However, as you pointed out, more still needs to be done to reinforce the foundations of our strategic partnership. This strategic partnership is the instrument for achieving the profound transformation of our country's economies. Let us join hands and hearts, of course. Sometimes it goes beyond just that. When hand in hand we find ourselves in marriage, which is another way of furthering our togetherness and our oneness. But let us join hands and promote cross-border investments, facilitate joint ventures, and other linkages between the public and private entities of our countries. Since last year's joint commission, we have embarked on reforms aimed at facilitating the ease, as they say, of doing business. We should improve the local business environment as well as stimulate investment flows, by the way. Last year, I also announced our government's legislative proposals aimed that reinforcing and further expanding the economic reforms we are undertaking. These proposals, once passed into law, will reduce delays in the registration of new businesses. Legislation should also provide the legal underpinning to the one-stop shop investment center, to which you have already made reference, and open new investment opportunities in infrastructure, especially that of our airports, roads and railway systems. We are also set to sign agreements on cooperation in energy and information communications technologies. Once signed, the agreements will create yet more opportunities for closer cooperation between us in the key strategic and critical sectors for the transformation and development of our economies. And they talk of for ICT. Protect our economies from those who would want to destroy them using this ICT technology. We don't have the means yet, and I don't think you also have means or adequate means yet. But I am aware that some of our friends have the means. Let's try to borrow those means from them and protect our economies from subversion and leave it open for the interaction between us, investments that flow either way, and the need for development that has found us meeting here for the second time. I mean, as a second meeting after the one we held last year. But may I invite our respective public and private sectors not to miss out on the opportunities that we are trying to provide for them. Under your chairmanship, Comrade President, we look forward to further progress in the implementation of the regional industrialization strategy. In view of the rapid frequency in the occurrence of climate change, there is need to develop a regional approach to disaster preparedness. You made reference to the disaster by way of drought that visited us the year before
just this last year, who were rewarded by Uncle Rains. But also Uncle Rains that come with that velocity and strength. And it leads to destruction of homes, to lands being flooded. They also bring disaster along the good that they bring along to enable our agriculture to prosper. So in both ways, on both sides, let us evolve those mechanisms of protecting ourselves from these disasters that have been evolved over time, and the new ones, or more to these ones, can still be evolved. In December this year, Comrade President, your party, the African National Congress, will hold a congress at which its future leadership will be elected. We're talking about the ANC now. So we wish the ANC every success at that Congress so that it can continue into the future renewed and strengthened. I don't know what we will be. If change, destruction of apartheid, without the future. Even of ourselves, the neighbors, we derive our life from what happened in 1912, with our future, will be prosperous. Others entirely on their own, jumping the border, going to work on the farms. The good and the bad. And we've given you the trouble to sort out. National Commission is not a once-a-year scheduled encounter, such as the one we are having today. We are meeting to continue and continue even when we are not meeting, as summits of the by National Commission, and the minister must continue to meet. The officials of the ministries must continue to meet. Above all, we must continue to think and think and think ahead, all of us. When our commission is not in session as it is now. And so it is and should be a constantly active forum for engagement and consultation. One always ready and available for our joint use. We look to the east, to the west, northwards and southwards, and we say to ourselves, the south, and only the south. Yes, frontline states. Yes, SADC. Yes, our parties. We fought the most devastating struggle. I would say struggle because it was one when it was here in South Africa, or in Zimbabwe. On a joint basis, that the struggle of one country was a struggle of another. True, Algeria had fought the French. Insisted that the rest of Africa, Francophone Africa, would get independence, but not Algeria, because it was part, as the goal emphasized, it was part of France. Don't tell us of the existence of the Mediterranean Sea in between. No. To have that secret training, the holding arms which he had before he returned here to get arrested. We are one. One people. One revolution. Perhaps this one might be new. And I tease him and say, only God has three persons, should have three persons. And you have what amounts to three ministries and three persons, and you're the only one who is like God. In my ministry, he's Minister of Transport, Roads, Railway, Airways, Comrade. Sent away from Guru-Mohan's. Guru-Mohan was the first state secondary school. He was playing politics there at Form 2. And they sent him away when he was a kid. And the chief used to myself to see him. Yeah, he is, oh, featured. Very hard work. sense the fruits are not really in relation to your struggle. You struggle, sometimes the fruits are not good, but you go on struggling with your friend again, Haiti. Well, we struggled and won. We had Madame Zuma elected as the first chairman of the commission of the EU. They are strong. They know each other, and they know the hard work that they put in place. They tried again yesterday, and it was another lady from Botswana. But you know, with Zuma, Africa had no problem. Yes, she was a lady from South Africa, a refugee in South Africa, where we derived our knowledge of the struggle. There are a lot more things as I think. But not so important. The poor lady, what she could do as Madame Zuma had done. We worked hard. They worked hard. Sweated. They sweated. You sweated. We sweated. One man did not sweat. He stayed at home. And expected that wonders would happen. They didn't happen. We were very sorry. Everybody just said, ah, you? We have not seen your president here. He doesn't attend our meetings. And what would happen if we placed our organization in your hands, in his hands? So sorry, lady, but we won't give you the votes. She worked hard. She was very sorry to lose. We were sorry also with him, and we knew in advance that we were trying a very impossible one. So we lost in that case. Yes, double again, citizen of Europe. He is our ambassador here. And he knows that double citizenship. I hope he has been behaving himself well and not abusing the duality of his citizens. Okay. After I indicate that I'm getting something else, yes, permanent secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, his brother is a minister, he's here, he's a deputy. The heir of the sun and visiting a photographer. He's now the minister. Or his brother, his younger brother, is the minister of industry. And very important for him because he has a lot to learn from the development, developed industries here. And he's the one who tries to protect our nascent industries, and he's also, I was going to say, famous, but I'm sure infamous for it. Because when he sometimes he puts on tariffs and so. we want our small industry to protect and not to be vanquished by the greatness of the big right to say now whether let's have a free trade along the way. But perhaps some who want this delegation or not, who have the chance, who have been given a chance to supply some. And so this president,
Thank you, Minister Twele. You may go back to your seat. I now have the honor to invite the Minister of Environmental Affairs of the Republic of South Africa to join Minister Mbengwe for the signing of the Memorandum of Understanding between the Republic of South Africa and the Republic of Zimbabwe on cooperation in the field of environment and conservation. Ministers. Excellencies, allow me to invite the Minister of Sports and Recreation of the Republic of South Africa, Minister Ncesi, to come forth for the signing of the Memorandum of Understanding between the Republic of South Africa and the Republic of Zimbabwe on cooperation in the field of sports and recreation. Ministers. Thank you. Minister of Energy, Minister Kubai, to join Minister Mubengwepe to sign the last MOU for today, which is the Memorandum of Understanding between the Republic of South Africa and the Republic of Zimbabwe on cooperation in the field of energy. Minister. Excellencies, the Presidents, may I now invite the Minister of International Relations and Cooperation of the Republic of South Africa, Minister Ngwana Mashabane, to join the Minister of Foreign Affairs to sign the agreed minutes of the Binational Commission between the Republic of South Africa and the Republic of Zimbabwe. This will be followed by the reading of the joint communique by Minister Ngwana Mashabane. Over to you, ministers. Thank you.
Your Excellencies, at the invitation of His Excellency, Mr. James of the Republic of South Africa, His Excellency, Sir Robert Gabriel Mugabe, President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, visited the Republic of South Africa from the 2nd to the 3rd October 2017 on the occasion of the second session of the Binational Commission between the Republic of South Africa and the Republic of Zimbabwe. The meeting of the two heads of states was preceded by a ministerial meeting which took place on the 2nd of October 2017 and a senior officials meeting held from the 28th to the 29th September of 2017. During the official talks, the two heads of state exchanged views on a wide range of bilateral, regional, and international issues of mutual interest. The two presidents reviewed bilateral relations and expressed satisfaction with the state of those relations. They agreed that the implementation of the agreements on the Binational Commission signed by both countries on the 8th of April 2015 was the most effective way of enhancing cooperation between the two countries. They also reaffirmed the strategic importance of the BNC mechanism in promoting political, economic, social, security, cultural, scientific, and technical cooperation. The two heads of state reviewed a progress report from the ministers on the implementation of agreements signed and commitments made, as well as decisions adopted at the first session of the Binational Commission. The two heads of state expressed their satisfaction with progress so far achieved. Having noted the developments on the one-stop border post at Bay Bridge, Musina, they welcomed the establishment of the Joint Technical Committee, whose mandate, among other things, will be to develop the necessary legal framework for the project. The two heads of state reaffirmed the strategic importance of this project and directed the relevant ministers to fast-track its operationalization. It's just been confirmed that this is the busiest border post on the continent, on the African continent. The two heads of states noted the existence of agreements, bilateral agreements, both signed historically, and the five that has just been signed this afternoon. The two heads of state reiterated their commitment to improving and strengthening the two economic relations between the two countries by facilitating trade and removing impediments constraining bilateral trade and investment. The two heads of state exchanged views on the political and security situation in the region. They further reaffirmed their commitment to working together in pursuit of sustainable peace, stability, and economic development in our region. His Excellency President Mugabe further congratulated His Excellency President Zuma for his election as the chair of SADC and reassured him of Zimbabwe's support during South Africa's tenure as chair of our regional organization. The two presidents reaffirmed their commitment to SADC and underscored the importance of having member states participate at the appropriate level during SADC summits. The two presidents welcomed the admission of Comoros into the SADC family. The two presidents congratulated the people of the Republic of Angola for conducting peaceful, fair, and credible elections. They further congratulated His Excellency Lerato for his election as President of Angola and committed themselves to working with him in pursuit of peace, stability, and economic integration of the region. The two presidents reviewed developments in the region, in particular the situation in Lesotho and the Democratic Republic of Congo. They further urged the two countries to implement the relevant SADC decisions and recommendations. The two presidents reaffirmed their commitments to the continental integration processes and called for the implementation of the African Union's Agenda 2063 and its seven aspirations of the Africa we want and its action plan. The two heads of state reviewed the political developments on the continent and expressed their concern on the ongoing instability in some parts of the continent. In this regard, they reaffirmed their commitment to work together in pursuit of sustainable peace and stability. The two presidents reaffirmed the two countries' long-standing solidarity with the people of the Sahrawi Arab Republic and Palestine. With regards to the Sarawak Republic, the two heads of states reaffirmed the need for SADC to convene a solidarity conference with the people of Western Sahara. The two presidents reaffirmed their support and commitment to the Agenda 2030 for Sustainable Development adopted by the United Nations in 2015. They reiterated the call for the reform of the multilateral global system of governments and in particular the UN Security Council. His Excellency President Mugabe expressed his gratitude for the warm reception and hospitality accorded to him and his delegation. He extended an invitation to His Excellency President Zuma to a working visit to Zimbabwe in 2018 for the third session of our PNC on a date to be mutually agreed upon through diplomatic channels. Done at Pretoria, the Republic of South Africa, 3rd October 2017. Zikom,
Kenya. Thank you
very much, Minister. We have now come to the end of this ceremony. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, may I kindly request you to please the President's take leave. Thank you.
I know what comes.